Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Welcome all the devotees who are joining us for today's Sunday Satsang program. Every week on Sundays at Vedic Cultural Center, we recite a chapter from Srimad Bhagavatam. So as of last week, we have completed first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. And today we are going to start with second canto, second khanda of Srimad Bhagavatam. I'd like to welcome Ajit Prabhu, Lalit Ji, Ujjwal Ji, Hare Krishna, and thank you for joining us. To all the friends who are joining us online, we'd like to welcome you all for today's Sunday Satsang program. The coming week is a very auspicious week. A lot of festivities are starting as per the Vedic calendar. Today is the auspicious day, disappearance day of Madhvacharya. Yesterday was disappearance day of Sri Ramanujacharya. These are the great saints from South India and from our Vedic culture. And upcoming on 23rd of February is Ekadashi, very auspicious day. Following that, we have Nityananda Trayodashi, and Varaha Dwadashi is also coming up soon. After the Ekadashi is the Varaha Dwadashi, and then is the Nityananda Trayodashi. So very auspicious week coming up. In this week, we will pray. We try to spend as much time for the spiritual practices. And today, we will begin with our recitation of second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. And before we begin, we will offer Mangalacharan invocation prayers. So Mangalacharan prayers are on your screen. You can repeat along with me. ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदामय्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपदान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपीकांत राधाकांत नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण। सो वी ऑल विल रिसाइट ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय 3 टाइम्स टुगेदर। Wherever you are, sit straight, back in the nine with the neck. Keep your eyes closed and repeat along with me. We'll recite Om, then Namo, then Bhagavate Vasudevaya 3 times together. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. They're not able to hear me. One second. We'll pause. Some technical difficulty here. One second, I'm just going to reconnect everything. There is some technical technical difficulty at our end, so we are trying to correct. Can you hear me? Hare Krishna, Ujjwalji, can you hear me? Thank you so much. Thank you, Hare Krishna. So we'd like to welcome all and thank you for joining us for today's Sunday's program. So today we are going to read from second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. We are going to start with the chapter number 1. We will revise briefly what we recited last week from Srimad Bhagavatam. And then we'll continue with the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. I'm just waiting for the screen to appear here for our friends online. I hope they can see the screen. Can you see my presentation here? Ujjwalji, can you see it? Lalit Prabhu, Nolinji, can you see the presentation? I think there is some technical problem. Okay, I'm going to share the presentation. Just give me a few seconds. I'm going to adjust the screen here. Okay, just a second. I'm going to adjust it. I'm going to adjust. They can't see the presentation, so. Just a second, I'm going to stop sharing and then share application. This one, I hope this one works now. Showing something happening here, but it's okay. I think it's coming up. Just give me one second. Should stop. Okay, I think they can see it now. Can you all see the screen?
Yeah.
Hare Krishna. Yeah, okay, good. Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Thank you. ग्रंथराज श्रीमद भागवतम की जय शिल प्रभुपाद की जय सो श्रीमद भागवतम हैज दिस 12 कैंटोस एंड वी आर ऑन द सेकंड कैंटो ऑफ श्रीमद भागवतम दिस ऑल कैंटोस आर जस्ट लाइक डिफरेंट ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णस शरीर लॉर्ड कृष्णस बॉडी इज नथिंग बट श्रीमद भागवतम एंड वी आर टेकिंग दर्शन सो फर्स्ट कैंटो ऑफ श्रीमद भागवतम is the lotus feet, right feet. And then the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam is the left feet of Lord Krishna. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu described Srimad Bhagavatam as Amala Puran. Amala Puran means which has no tinge of any material desires. If we sincerely hear Srimad Bhagavatam, hearing means understanding and applying in our life. That means hearing. Hearing does not shravanam, but andar jana hai, absorb in our life. Then our life will be purified. Srimad Bhagavatam is a conversation, question answers, basically happening at the beginning of Kali Yuga. The sages have accumulated in the Naimisharanya, and the conversation is happening. And Sutta Goswami, who is the realized soul who has learned Srimad Bhagavatam from Sukadev Goswami, is reciting the Bhagavatam Katha. And we are learning from life of Parikshit Maharaj. Parikshit Maharaj committed an offense, and he put a snake, a dead snake, around the neck of, what was the neck of the Rishi? Shamik Rishi. Very, very nice. And then he was ultimately cursed to die within 7 days. It was given, the Shamik Rishi's son, Sringi, gave a curse that Parikshit Maharaj will die within 7 days by Takshaka. And Parikshit Maharaj then decides that he is going to do prayaschitta, repentance. So what does Parikshit Maharaj do? He leaves the kingdom, and he goes to the bank of Yamuna River, which is next to the Hastinapur, next to the Delhi. And Parikshit Maharaj starts meditating upon lotus feet of Lord Shri Krishna. At that time, when all the sages across the universe, they hear that Parikshit Maharaj has been cursed by Sringi to die within 7 days, Parikshit Maharaj is fasting and he is meditating and he is sitting there, Yamuna River. And at that time, all the great sages arrives there, which included great rishis like Gautam Rishi, Angira Rishi, Narada, Vyasa, Devala. All these great, great Rishi Munis arrived there. And at that time, Shukadev Goswami also arrived. And we learned about the physical description of Shukadev Goswami. Shukadev Goswami is the great son of Vyasji. And Shukadev Goswami is a realized soul. His body complexion was just like Lord Krishna. He appeared like blue in color. He had very thin hands. And he was looking like a madman with long hairs. So the kids who were following him, they were chastising him, thinking him like a madman. But Parikshit Maharaj, Shukadev Goswami was not a mad person. He was a realized soul. So when Shukadev Goswami appeared, all the sages in Naimisharanya, all the sages who accumulated not at Naimisharanya but at by the Ganga River, by Hastinapur, Yamuna River, by Hastinapur, everybody paid respects to Shukadev Goswami. And then Parikshit Maharaj, who is the king himself, here you can see Parikshit Maharaj sitting there in front of Shukadev Goswami here. Parikshit Maharaj bows down his head to Shukadev Goswami. And Parikshit Maharaj asks questions to Shukadev Goswami. Now here is Parikshit Maharaj, who is about to die within 7 days. He has been cursed by Sringi. And Parikshit Maharaj has given up his kingdom, has given up his royal opulences. He has given up the food. He is fasting actually. And he is repenting that I have done a mistake and I should suffer for whatever the mistake I have done. So Parikshit Maharaj, first of all, he pays respects to Shukadev Goswami, and then he tells him, Ata pruchhami sam siddhim He says, I prichami. Prichami is a Sanskrit word which means I beg. I am begging you. So that's a humility. When we ask from a teacher, we should be a humble, very humble. Huh? So here's the king becoming humble, and who is begging to a sannyasi. Usually sadhus beg from the Gruhastha or king, but here king is begging and he's saying to Sukadev Goswami, Atha Prachami Samasiddhim Yogi Nam Paramam Guru. He says, hey Sukadev Goswami, you are the supreme master, the great spiritual master among all the saints and devotees. So whenever we meet a great personality, we say some good words about him. Glorify them in a true sense. So when we meet our Guru Maharaj, we glorify them. Like when we come here and see Krishna, what do? We glorify Krishna. How do we glorify Krishna? Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpati Gopesha Gopikanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrinda Vaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye. So in this way we are glorifying Sri Radha and Krishna by beautiful prayers. As well, if you don't remember the Sanskrit prayers, then you can say, hey Krishna, hey Radha, you are looking so beautiful. You are wearing such a nice dress today. Isn't Lord Krishna wearing a nice dress today? Isn't he looking beautiful? If you are wearing nice dress, if somebody says you are looking good, you feel better. Eh? That is why we go to beauty parlor, we dress up. Because somebody appreciates you, right? Similarly, Krishna is dressed up so nicely. So we say, Krishna, you are looking so beautiful. And Krishna will like it very much. Krishna will be very happy if you come and appreciate him. And then when we come to temple also, we dress up also very nicely. Why do we dress up nicely? When you go to meet some VIP, don't you dress up nicely? Jab aap shaadi mein jaate hai, kisi ko milne ko jaate hai, you dress up nicely. So jab bhagwan ke mandir aate hai, tab bhi achha dress pehen ke aana chahiye. Best se best kapde. Not to show business, but then to... We are coming to see Krishna, so Krishna will be happy that we are coming to see him in a nice dress. So he will feel better, and we also come here not to show to anybody else, but to please Krishna. Gopis used to dress very nicely. Why? Because they want to attract Krishna. Like that. So whatever we do in our life, we do it for pleasure of Krishna. So here, Parikshit Maharaj is saying to Sukadev Goswami, so Sukadev Goswami, you are Yogi Nam Paramam Guru. You are the spiritual master of great devotees. So I want to ask you some questions. Can I please ask you questions? Very humility is very important. So Parikshit Maharaj is asking questions to Sukadev Goswami. And what is Parikshit Maharaj asking questions? Usually, when we ask something from someone, we ask for ourselves. Is that right? If you meet some sadhu or saint, what do you ask? When will I get a job? When will I get my things sorted out? You know, everybody has some or other problem. Somebody says, I want, ask whatever you want. So what do you ask? You ask something material. But Parikshit Maharaj asked to Sukadev Goswami, he says that, please tell me, Ata Prichami Samsiddhim. Please tell me what is perfection in the human life. How can we become perfect in our life? Everybody wants to be perfect. So Parikshit Maharaj is asking that, what is the perfection in human life. What? And then second question he asks is, what should one do when one is about to die? So when we meet a guru, we ask the questions which are ultimately good for everyone in general. So what is the first question? What is the perfection? What is the best for all the human at large? And what one should do when he or she is about to die? What is the best thing for one to do when he is about to die? Because everybody is going to die, right? So what does the death mean? Parikshit Maharaj is going to die within 7 days. So he is asking, what should be the duty of a person who is about to die? Next, Parikshit Maharaj asks, what should one hear, chant, and remember? And what should one not do? Right? So these are all questions Parikshit Maharaj is asking, which are relevant for all of us, because we all are going to die. We all want to be perfect in our life. We want ultimately achieve the highest perfection in our life. We hear so many things, but we don't know what is good for us, what is bad for us. We do talk so many things, but we don't know what is to be talked, what is not to be talked. Sometimes we remember the things which are not to be remembered. So here Parikshit Maharaj is asking general question for the benefit of all of us. That was in the first canto, 19th chapter. So then to answer that, we enter into the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, first chapter is titled as The First Step in God Realization. So here Shukadev Goswami starts answering the questions. So Shukadev Goswami says, Shri Shuka Vacha Varyaneshate Prashna Kruto Lokahitam Drupa. So Shukadev Goswami is a realized saint. So he immediately understands what is Parikshit Maharaj wanting. Whenever you meet a realized guru, a realized personality, that person will immediately understand what is there in your mind. कभी कभी साधु संतों को जब आप मिलते हैं तो आपको लगता है कि हम इनको बाहर से अच्छा दिखाएंगे तो, लेकिन उनको इमीडिएटली मालूम हो जाता है कि इनके मन में क्या चल रहा है. हमारे गुरु महाराज है गोपाल कृष्ण गोस्वामी महाराज. तो जब भी कोई उनको मिलता है तो महाराज हरेक को अलग अलग प्रश्न पूछते हैं, और वो प्रश्न ऐसे पूछते हैं कि वो आदमी के सिचुएशन के अप्रोप्रिएट है. जैसे कोई डिवोटी मिलेगा तो उसको पूछेंगे कि आप जप करते हो? ऐसा क्यों पूछते? क्योंकि उनको मालूम है कि ये जप नहीं करता है. फिर दूसरे को पूछेंगे कि मंदिर में कैसे चल रहा है, तो उनको मालूम है कि ये जप करता है, मंदिर में सेवा नहीं करता है. ऐसे हरेक को अलग अलग प्रश्न पूछेंगे, क्योंकि महाराज को मालूम रहता है कि इनके मन में क्या चल रहा है. तो यहाँ पे शुकदेव गोस्वामी इमीडिएटली अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज हैपनिंग विथ इन द माइंड ऑफ परीक्षित महाराज. सो शुकदेव गोस्वामी ग्लोरिफाइड परीक्षित महाराज एंड ही सेड दैट वरियान एश ते प्रश्न. वरियान मीन्स ग्लोरियस. द क्वेश्चंस यू हैव आस्क्ड आर वेरी ग्लोरियस. व्हाई? बिकॉज कृतः लोकहितम नृपः. नृप इज किंग. ओ किंग, द क्वेश्चन यू हैव आस्क्ड इज बेनिफिशियल फॉर एवरीबडी. सो यूजुअली डिवोटीज ऑफ लॉर्ड आर वेल विशर्स ऑफ एवरीबडी. भगवान के जो भक्त है वो किसी से ईर्ष्या नहीं करते हैं. दे आर ईगर टू सर्व अदर्स. दे डू नॉट हैव एनी बैड फीलिंग्स. or any hatredness or jealousy for others. They are always thinking about welfare of others. That is, Srila Prabhupada ji used to say that devotee is defined by one whose mind is always engaged in welfare of others. What did I say? Mind should always be trained to think welfare of others. This is what Srila Prabhupada used to say. Here Parikshit Maharaj is thinking about welfare of others. What is he thinking about? He's saying, my dear, he is thinking that how can we be perfect in the human life and what one should do at the time of death. So Parikshit Maharaj is asking a question which is applicable for all of us. We are going to die one day. So how should we train our mind in such a way that our death becomes successful? Usually, whatever we think at the time of death, that is what happens to our next life. Anta kale cha mama eva smaram yukta kalevaram. So whatever we are thinking at the time of death, we achieve that in our next life. Most of the people, when they are dying, they are thinking about their physical body or they are thinking about their family or friends. Most of the people. It is very difficult even to think about anything else because that is what we are doing all the time. Now our mind is a very powerful. Whatever we are thinking is because of mind. You understand? जब आप रात को सो जाते हैं तो आपका मन क्या करता है? काम करते रहता है, सोचते रहता है. Our mind works 24/7, 365 days a year, as long as we are alive. And what is mind always thinking about? Mind is always thinking about ourselves. Right? आप सुबह से उठे शाम तक आपने दूसरे के बारे में कुछ सोचा आज? आज हम इसको कैसे हेल्प करें ऐसा सोचा आपने? सुबह से उठ के आपने कुछ सोचा ऐसा? हम ऐसा कभी नहीं सोचते हैं कि हम दूसरे के लिए आज क्या करेंगे. हम क्या करते हैं? आज मैं मेरे लिए क्या करूंगा, है ना? ऐसे ही करते हैं. स्पेशली सपोज यू आर गोइंग टू डाई, व्हाट विल यू डू? विल यू थिंक अबाउट एनीबडी एल्स इफ यू आर गोइंग टू डाई? यू विल थिंक दैट हाउ कैन आई सेव माई बॉडी और हाउ कैन आई write my will or how can I give my property to my children? Is that right? Parikshit Maharaj was about to die and he gave up his kingdom. He did not stay there for even 1 second. And he immediately started concentrating on Lord Krishna's lotus feet. And now on the top he is thinking that when he met a great sage like Shukadeva Goswami and all the great sages who accumulated there, Parikshit Maharaj's mind is now thinking about others, that I am going to die, similarly other people are also going to die in my life. Right? Do you think anybody of us is going to stay here forever? Aapke ghar mein ped hai, if you have a small plant at your home, plant hai ghar pe. जैसे हमारे घर पे तुलसी का एक वृक्ष है, पेड़ है, पेड़ नहीं पौधा है, सॉरी. सो वी हैव अ तुलसी प्लांट एंड एवरी डे व्हेन आई गो टू टेंपल इन अवर टू रूम आई सी दैट सम लीव्स हैव फॉलन डाउन. आपके यहाँ भी ऐसा होता रहेगा, फिर नए पत्ते आ जाते हैं नेक्स्ट डे. व्हाट डज दैट सीन? व्हेन यू सी दैट फॉलिंग लीफ, व्हाट डू यू थिंक अबाउट? That this leaf was alive yesterday and today this leaf is not there. Yesterday it was green, today it is brown. And as it became brown, it fell off from the plant. Similarly, today I am alive, but tomorrow I am going to fall off just like this leaf. है ना? जैसे ये पत्ता गिर गया है, वैसे मैं भी एक दिन गिर जाऊंगा. So mind is always thinking about ourselves. So why not I start thinking about Krishna? Or why not I think that how can I engage my mind in service of Krishna and service of devotees of Krishna? Like that. So mind is a training, you know. And the Ashtanga Yoga, Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. This is all mind training workshop. Bhagavad Gita is a mind training. There's nothing else. So man ka khel hai, you know. आप रात को सो जाते हैं तो नींद में कभी लायन आता है, टाइगर आता है, पीपल स्टार्ट शाउटिंग इन स्लीप. व्हाई? बिकॉज माइंड इज वर्किंग. देयर इज नो टाइगर और लायन, बट द माइंड इज थिंकिंग लाइक दैट. समटाइम्स somebody इज वेरी नाइस टू यू एंड देन द सेम पर्सन बिकम्स जेलस टू यू. व्हाई? बिकॉज ऑफ द माइंड. माइंड इज अ वेरी पावरफुल ऑर्गन. So Prabhupada ji says, if you really want to train your mind, then train it in such a way to think good about others. Don't be envious of others. So Shukadev Goswami, when he heard the questions of Parikshit Maharaj, Shukadev Goswami said, my dear king, your question is glorious. It is very beneficial for all the humanities. Then Shukadev Goswami said, that generally people ask questions, and what are the qualities of questions? So here Shukadev Goswami is saying that everybody wants to hear something. Aap news padhte ho? Aap WhatsApp dekhte ho? Some people check Facebook, WhatsApp, newspaper. Why? Because everybody wants to know something new, right? Roz naya kuch message aana chahiye. So Shukadev Goswami saying to Parikshit Maharaj, Shrotavya Adini Rajendra Naram Shanti Shahastrashah Apashyatam Atmatatvam Griheshu Grahamedhinam. So here Shukadev Goswami is saying that Rajendra is the king of the emperor, you know, king of all the kings, Raj among all the, Indra among all the Rajas, Rajendra. There's a name called Narendra. Narendra means Indra among the king among the human beings, that is Narendra. And Rajendra means the emperor of the emperor. Like that. So he's saying, Shrotavya Adini Rajendra. In a human society, there are a lot of subject matter for hearing. Naram Shanti Shahastra Shaha. Shahastra means thousands and thousands of topics for talking. You know, people like to hear, and there are thousands and thousands of topics. But Apashyatam Atma Tattvam. Apashyatam means those who are blind. What is the blindness? There are two types of blindness. One is material blindness, who cannot see, and one is spiritual blindness. Griheshu Grahamedhinam. This is a very important verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, second canto. There are types of people who are spiritually blind. They are called Grahamedhinam. Grahamedhinam. There is one word called as Grahastha. You understand the word Grihastha? Grihastha means one who is married, one who has a wife, children, family. And there is another Shabda which is called Grihamedhi. Grihamedhi means Grihastha, one who is married, but his entire life is engaged in sense gratification. There are four dharmas, four ashramas. One is Brahmachari ashram, then Grihastha ashram, then Vanaprastha and Sanyas ashram. Brahmachari means up to 25 years of age you are not married. That's called Brahmachari. Then you get married. That is Grihastha. But the same Grihastha can become Grahamedhi. What is Grahamedhi? What is the difference between Grihastha and Grahamedhi? So Grihastha is married person having wife and children, but his life is centered around Krishna consciousness, serving around Krishna. And Grihamedhi means same married person having wife and children, but everything for sense gratification, for self-benefit. So when Grihastha, he has wife and children, so what he thinks? That how we as a family can serve Krishna. While the same married person, same married family, they think as a Grihamedhi, how we can have more sense gratification, how we can have more for ourselves rather than for anybody else. Everything for us, nothing for others. So that is the difference between Grihastha and Grihamedhi. You understood this? So it is not that marriage life is not suitable for Krishna consciousness. Marriage life is suitable. But when we use whatever the marriage facility we have, you know, for service of Krishna, that is Grihastha life. And same marriage life can become a source of misery when it is Grihamedhi. So even Pandavas were Grihastha. Pandavas were married. There are a lot of devotees like Srila Prabhupada ji or even Bhakti Vinod Thakur. All these were married. Marriage is suitable for spiritual advancement when we use the marriage life for service of Krishna. So husband and wife and children all are engaged in the spiritual progress, then that marriage life is successful. But when the same marriage life becomes the problem of life because of the ego, sense gratification. So husband and wife, each wants to satisfy their own ego, and then there is a problem. But when there is center of activity is Krishna, that is called Grihastha life. And then the center of activity is yourself. Prabhupada used to say, sometimes the marriage life is like scratching the back. I scratch your back, you scratch my back. And then if you cannot scratch my back, then you're not related to me. Because I need your service, you need my service. But here, we all are serving Krishna. That is the ideal condition. That is the Grihastha. So, Shrotavya Adi Rajendra Niram Shanti Shastrasha Apashyatam Atma Tattvam Griheshu Griha Medinam. Here, Shukadeva Goswami is saying to Parikshit Maharaj, hey Parikshit Maharaj, you are Grihastha, you are married, you have children. Parikshit Maharaj had children. Parikshit Maharaj was married. But Parikshit, you are such a wonderful that you gave up your kingdom and now you are asking for the benefit of everybody else. However, the persons who are materially engrossed, Grahashu Grahamedinam, materially engaged. Apashyatam Atma Tattvam, who are blind to spirituality. For those people, there are hundreds and thousands of subject matter for hearing. What are those matters? Politics. Then industry. A lot of people they gossip, you know, whole time they're gossiping. Chum yum chum yum. What is going on? Whole time is not a single moment they are what to do. Some people like talking and hearing. They're never quiet for a moment. You tell them if you keep quiet, I'll give you a gift. They won't keep quiet. There's one this is not for the devotees, for those who are, this is in general I'm talking, don't take it personally. This Graha Medhina, Medhi is a Sanskrit word. Medhi means jealous. Actually, origin of Medha is means jealous, one who is jealous. Actually, Grihasthas, they are jealous of each other. Aapke ghar mein 23 inch ka TV, mere paas 50 inch ka TV. Aapke paas 50, mere paas 70 inch ka TV. And wo kehte na, meri saadi te se safed kaise hai, meri saadi se safed kaise hai. So this is the nature of a Grihamedhi. Grihamedhi means the person who are
jealous of others. While grihastha is very happy, par dukhe sukhi. उसको कहते हैं ग्रह मेधी, तुम्हारे घर में आग लग गई मुझे बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है, बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है कि आपका नुकसान हो गया, मुझे अच्छा लग रहा है. लेकिन गृहस्थ विल बी पर दुखे दुखी. इफ यू आर रियली अनहैप्पी देन द गृहस्थ विल फील बैड फॉर यूर. सो कृष्ण डिवोटी इज अ गृहस्थ, वाइल ग्रह मेधी मीन्स मटेरियलिस्टिक पर्सन. So envious is the quality of grahamedhi. So this is not to judge others. This is to judge ourselves. What, how we feel. ये दूसरे किसी के लिए नहीं है, ये अपने लिए है. So Srimad Bhagavatam shows us the path of self-realization. So here Shukadev Goswami is saying to King that those persons who are materially engrossed, being blind to the knowledge of ultimate truth, have many subject matter for hearing in this human society. So who is spiritually blind? Spiritually blind means that who does not have desire to know what is the ultimate purpose of my life. Is it my life is to get some degree, get some good job, get married, produce some children, get a house, get a car, get old and then die, and then get another body, and then again go through the same cycle. Again you take another father, mother, again another birth, then again the same situation. Punarapi janma, punarapi. So most of the people, like, you know, if you have seen in the type of Eid, they bali, they cut the goat, bakre ko marte hain. So what do? They feed the goat green grass. And then in the market, they sell this goat. Lots of goats are there. Every goat is very happy because every goat is getting green grass. So goat is eating. But that goat does not know that she's going to get cut next moment, actually, right? So that is the situation of most of the people, that we are enjoying, just like a goat is enjoying the green grass and she's being cut next moment. Hai na, bakre ko kaise karte? Kaat dete. Lekin kaatne ke pehle uske samne green grass rakha jata hai. Kyunki wo goat ko malum nahi hai. Wo to khane mein magna hai. Immediately ek tawar aati hai aur cut ho jata. Similarly, most of us are engrossed in enjoying the day-to-day life, which is what Shukadev Goswami is saying, that most of the people on the planet, they are busy in enjoying the material life, but they do not know that when that sword of death will come and they will engage. So we are working very hard. Subah se raat tak bahut mehnat karte hai. क्यों? तो गोट के जैसा कल अच्छा दिन आएगा, कल गाड़ी आएगी, बंगला आएगा, ये हो जाएगा, वो हो जाएगा. यू नेवर नो, राइट? सो दिस इज व्हाट शुकदेव गोस्वामी इज सेइंग. देन फर्दर शुकदेव गोस्वामी इज सेइंग टू परीक्षित महाराज, निद्रा ह्यते नक्त राजन, निद्रा ह्यते नक्तम, व्यवायेन च वया दीव च अर्थे राजन. So here Shukadev Goswami is describing the materialistic life. Nidra yate naktam, nidraya, nidraya means soya jana. Everybody loves sleeping, right? So nidraya riyate naktam. Naktam means night. In the night time, people sleep. Vyava yena cha vayaha. Wasting their night in sleeping or in the materialistic affairs in the night time. Diva cha arthe ya rajan. Diva means daytime. अर्थ मीन्स इकोनॉमिक, यह मीन्स डेवलपमेंट एंड राजन. तो इन द डे टाइम व्हाट डू दे डू, एक जॉब से दूसरे जॉब, दूसरे जॉब से तीसरे जॉब, भागते रहते हैं लोग. क्या करते हैं? इन द डे टाइम दे थिंक अबाउट मनी, इन द नाइट टाइम दे थिंक अबाउट स्लीप, राइट, नथिंग एल्स. एंड देन कुटुंब भरने नवा, और ऑल दे व्हाई डू दे डू दिस, ऑल दिस एक्टिविटी, व्हाई आर दे रनिंग इन द डे टाइम, कुटुंब भरने नवा. So daytime they are running around to look after the family, and nighttime sleeping or indulgence in the material activities. And this is how they spend their life. So here the Parikshit Shukadev Goswami is saying the lifetime of a materialist person is passed at the night either in sleeping, and in the daytime either in making money or maintaining the families. So in this way, most of the people, they waste life. This is materialistic life. They do not have time for thinking about Krishna. They do not have time for thinking about how can I help somebody else? How can I go and serve Krishna? How can I read? Do you have time for Srimad Bhagavatam reading? Oh, no, no, sorry, I'm very busy. Do you have a time for chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra today? Oh, very busy today. What do I say? What did you do today? Well, I got up early in the morning. What time? At 10 o'clock. And then that was very early. Usually I get up at 2 o'clock afternoon. Today I got up early. Why? Because I had a job interview. And then I had an appointment or this or that. So this is the way we waste our materialistic life. This is like a goat, you know, that same goat is going to get cut the next moment. But the goat is still enjoying the food. Similarly, we don't know when our death is going to come, but we are planning for as if we are going to live forever. Hai na? Aisa lagta hai ki hazar saal ka jeevan hai. We will die any moment of the time, but we don't know when that moment is going to come. So Parikshit Shukadev Goswami is saying, hey Rajan, lifetime of this materialistic people is wasted. How is it wasted? Either in sleeping, or in the daytime making money. And is it true or false? Shukadev Goswami saying is wrong. Shukadev Goswami saying this 5,000 years ago, and we are doing the same thing since 5,000 years, or maybe before. We are going through the same. Further, Shukadev Goswami saying, Deha apatya kalatradishu atmasaineshu ashatsu api tesham pramotto nidhanam Pashyanam api na pashyati. So here, Shukadev Goswami is saying, Deha apatya kalatra adishu. Deha means this sharira. This body ko kya kehte hai? Deha. Apatya yane bacche, children. Kalatra means wife, adishu. आत्मसंयेशु असत्सु अपि. तेषां प्रमत्तो निधनं पश्यम अपि न पश्यति. सो द पर्सन्स हु डू नॉट हैव दिस मटेरियल पर्सन हु डू नॉट हैव दिस tendency to inquire about the self-realization, and those who are engrossed in this materialistic life, what are they doing? So they are spending their time for kutumba bharane nava. They are too much attached to their apatya. Apatya means children. Mera bachcha, mera ye, mera wo. And then meri wife, meri patni, my dear, my beloved. What else? There are a lot of good words for that. But this person, Shukadev Goswami is saying, is that Deha apatya kalatra adishu. Adishu means baki ke sab log. Bacche, meri patni. Adishu. Atma sainyeshu asatshu api. Atma. Sainya means kya? Sainya means kya? सैन्य यानी क्या? सैन्य है ना, सेना राइट, सोल्जर्स, दे आर सो मच अटैच टू दिस पीपल दैट दे थिंक दैट दिस इज माई आर्मी. वट इज द आर्मी? माई वाइफ, माई चिल्ड्रन, माई फैमिली, माई ब्रदर्स, माई सिस्टर्स. एंड वट इज द आर्मी डू? दे गोइंग टू सेव यू राइट, दे प्रोटेक्ट यू राइट. सो सच अ मटेरियलिस्टिक पर्सन थिंक्स दैट देह अपत्य कलत्र आदिशु आत्मसैन्यु असत्सु अपि तेषां प्रमोत्तो निधनम पश्य नाम अपि न पश्यति. उनको ऐसा लगता है कि ये बच्चे, बीवी, भाई बहन, ये सब मुझे बचा लेंगे, ये डॉक्टर भी बचाएगा, ये कंपाउंडर भी मुझे बचाएगा, ये फार्मासिस्ट भी मुझे बचाएगा. कोई किसी को बचाता? Nobody is going to save you, man. But still, they think that they are mine, and they are the one who are going to help me. काम कौन आएगा? यही काम में आने वाले हैं. But तेषां प्रमत्तो निधनम, they have seen निधनम. निधनम means destruction. These people have seen that same destruction had happened in their पश्यन्नपि पश्यति. They have seen that in the past, their father, their grandfather, their great great grandfather also thought like that, but all of them have died, isn't it? And they all were thinking that somebody will save them, but nobody saves anybody. So here Shukadev Goswami is saying that if you are really really inquisitive, then you should think that persons who are devoid of Atma Tattva do not inquire into the problems of life. Why? Because being too much attached to the fallible soldiers like body, children, wife, although sufficiently experienced, they still do not see their inevitable destructions. Our destruction is inevitable. We are going to die for sure. Hum marne wale hai, ye to likha hua hai. तो फिर वो गोट के जैसा खाना खा रहे, खाना खा रहे. इफ अ गोट इज वाइज, व्हाट विल गोट डू? शी विल ट्राई टू एस्केप फ्रॉम दैट बिकॉज शी इज गोइंग टू गेट कट, राइट? है क्या नहीं? द गोट इज गोइंग टू गेट कट विद इन नेक्स्ट फ्यू सेकंड्स. इंस्टेड ऑफ एंजॉयिंग द ग्रास, गोट कैन थिंक दैट हाउ कैन आई गेट आउट ऑफ दिस एंट्रैपमेंट एंड कैन आई रन अवे फ्रॉम दिस, because I'm going to get killed next moment. Is that right or wrong? है ना? अगर आपके सामने पंच पकवान रखा है और अगले मोमेंट आप मरने वाले हैं, क्या आप खाना खाएंगे? What will you do? You'll think, how do you escape from there? Right? Similarly, here Shukadev Goswami is saying that if you are intelligent, IQ थोड़ा ज्यादा है आपके पास, तो क्या करिए? सोचिए कि मेरे पूर्वज भी मर गए थे और मैं भी मरने वाला हूं, कुछ नहीं आने वाला है ना. वी हैव सीन दिस, लाइफ इज टेम्पररी एंड द रिलेशंस आर आल्सो टेम्पररी. हस्बैंड वाइफ, आई हैड अ लाइफ, आई हैड अ वाइफ, नाउ आई हैव अ लाइफ एंड आई हैव अ वाइफ, एंड इन द फ्यूचर आल्सो आई विल हैव अ लाइफ एंड वाइफ, सेम थिंग विल कंटिन्यू. देयर इज नथिंग going to change. So the intelligent person will think that, is there any way I can get out of this? Why am I going to get again and again and again? Isme se kuch bahar aa sakte hai? Why it is important? Because every time when we have a life, there is a misery associated with it. Punarapi janma, punarapi marna. Aur jab mrityu hoti hai to bahut dukh hota hai. Fir janma ke saath, fir janma mrityu, fir jara, fir dukh. शरीर के दुख, जरा ओल्ड एज, व्याधि. व्याधि मीन्स डिजीज, कंपल्सरी है ये सब, है ना. ऑल दिस आर कंपल्सरी थिंग्स एंड ऑल दिस प्रॉब्लम्स कैन नॉट बी सॉल्व्ड बाय वाइफ, चिल्ड्रन, फैमिली. दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू सॉल्व ऑल दिस प्रॉब्लम्स. फर्दर शुकदेव गोस्वामी सेइंग दैट तस्माद् भारत सर्वात्मा भगवान ईश्वरो हरि श्रोतव्य कीर्तितव्यश्च स्मर्तव्यश्च इच्छता भयम्. Tasmad is a Sanskrit word which means therefore. He's saying therefore, after going through all this, what did we talk about? About materialistic life. Materialistic life means grahashu graha medinam. Enviousness, sleeping, working hard, and then dying. No outcome. There's nothing positive here. So here, therefore, tasmat bharata sarvatma bhagavan ishvaro hari. Tasmat, therefore I am telling you, hey Parikshit, if you really want to abhayam means, you see the word abhayam at the end, smritavyascha ichchata abhayam, if you really want to become free from all these problems and the miseries of repeated cycle, birth, disease, old age and death, then bhagavan ishvaro hari shrotavya kirtitavyascha. Bhagavan ishvaro hari. Hari yani kya? Have you heard the word hari? Hari suna hai aapne? Hari yani kya? Let's see who is going to answer this. Hari, who is online here today with us? Hari, what does the word hari means? She is saying is correct. Hari means har lena, take it away from you. So what does Krishna take away from you? Hara means to take away. So when you surrender to Krishna, Krishna will take away all the miseries. Har lena. Krishna will take away all your problems of your life. Whatever is bad in your life, Krishna will take out. That is why Krishna is called Hari. That's why you say Hari Bol. What does Hari Bol means? Hey Krishna, you take away all the bad things from my life. Do you want bad things? No. So Lord, that is why Shukadeva Goswami is saying, Tasmad ekena manas, Tasmad Bharat Sarvatma, Bhagavan Ishwarori, Shrotavya Kirtitavyasya. Shrotavya means? Suitavyasya means bolna. So Shukadeva Goswami kehte hai ki, hey Raja Parikshit, therefore one who desires to be free from all the miseries must hear about, glorify and remember Hari, Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the super soul, controller and savior from all the miseries. Right? So people like to hear about a lot of things. People like to talk about a lot of things. But that hearing and talking tendency to be used in the service of Krishna. How? Shrotavya kirtitavyascha Bhagavan Ishwaro Hari. Kiske liye sunna hai? Bhagavan ke baare mein sunna hai. Kiske liye bolna hai? Bhagavan ke liye bolna hai. Kiske liye yaad rakhna hai? Bhagavan ke liye. Baki to kya yaad rakhe? Kahe main tujhe yaad rakh lunga. कुछ याद नहीं रखेंगे आप, भूल जाएंगे. हाँ, परसों क्या खाया था याद है आपको? कुछ याद नहीं है. लास्ट जन्म का भी कुछ याद नहीं, इस जन्म का भी कुछ याद नहीं है. तो सब भूल जाते हैं. जैसे उम्र बढ़ती है भूलना ज्यादा होता है, वो भूलते जाते हैं. अच्छी चीज भूलना चाहिए है ना. लेकिन तस्माद मीन्स देयरफॉर. Therefore, I am telling you, Shukadeva Goswami is saying to Parikshit Maharaj, if you really want to remember something, if you want to talk something, if you want to hear something, hear about Krishna. Nothing else is worth, because everything is going to be useless. Aap agar kuch bhi padhenge, newspaper padhenge, kal ka newspaper aaj basi ho jata hai, kya fayda uska? Lekin wahi samay agar aap Bhagavad Gita padhi to, kaam mein aayegi, hai na? Yes or no? When I was in grade 5-6, I learned a lot of geography. I don't remember anything. I wasted my life there like anything. I wish I could have learned Bhagavad Gita at that time. I could remember now. It would have helped me more. Is that right or wrong? A lot of things we learned in the medical school, and some of you forget a lot of things. I learned pharmacology so much, and I don't remember anything now. It's all waste of my life. I wasted my whole life there. Pharmacology. Oh my God, why did I learn that? So many things we waste our life. But imagine you spend that life in spiritual realization. Anytime you die, it will come with you next life. It will not get wasted. because Bhagavan Ishvara Hari, Ishvara Krishna is there in your heart. So when you remember Krishna in your heart, he is always going to be there. Bhagavan aapke saath abhi bhi hai aur agle janam mein bhi rahenge. To aapka jo relation hai Bhagavan ke saath permanent hai. Baki to sab relation hai na. कुछ लोग मिलते हैं तो भी पहचानते नहीं आपको क्यों, तो कि आप बहुत साल के बाद मिल रहे हैं उनको, चेहरा बदल गया है, शरीर बदल गया है. कभी कभी हमारे दोस्त मिलते हैं स्कूल के, और बहुत डिफरेंट दिख रहा है. आई डोंट रिकॉग्नाइज दोस पीपल, ही इज द सेम पर्सन बट आई डोंट रिकॉग्नाइज हिम बिकॉज ऑफ सो मेनी ईयर्स. योर बॉडी चेंजेस राइट. So here, but only thing which is permanent is Krishna. So if you develop relationship with Krishna, this is the perfect process. Now hearing is very, very important. But the hearing from whom is also very important. Shrotavya Kirtitavyasya. So that is further explained by Shukadev Goswami. Further Shukadev Goswami is saying to Parikshit Maharaj, how to achieve perfection. So Parikshit Maharaj had asked the question, what is to be heard, what is not to be heard, right? What is ultimate good for everyone? Now Parikshit Maharaj had also asked the question that what is the highest perfection of human life? Is that right? So here Shukadev Goswami is answering that question.
Hetavan Sankhya Yogabhyam स्वधर्म परिनिष्ठया जन्मलभ परपुंसां अंधे नारायण स्मृति.
ये लास्ट जो है येलो में लिखा है, देखिए, कैन यू ऑल सी, अंधे नारायण स्मृति. तो आप मेरे पीछे रिपीट करिए,
अंधे नारायण स्मृति, अंधे नारायण स्मृति, अंते नारायण स्मृति, एतावान् सांख्ययोगाभ्यं स्वधर्म परिनिष्ठया जन्मलाभ परपुंसां अंते नारायण स्मृति.
जन्मलाभ परपुंसां, पर मीन्स सुप्रीम. आपको मनुष्य जन्म मिला है, इसका लाभ, परम लाभ क्या है? तो अंते नारायण स्मृति. जानवर को ये लाभ नहीं मिलता है. कैन अ डॉग रिमेंबर कृष्णा एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ? मे बी, वी डोंट नो, बट चांसेस आर लेस. कैन अ पिग रिमेंबर कृष्णा एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ? कैन अ मॉस्किटो रिमेंबर कृष्णा एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ? यस और नो? हाईली अनलाइकली, यू नेवर नो, बट हाईली अनलाइकली. जन्म लाभ परपुंसां अंते नारायण स्मृति. सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेइंग एतावान् सांख्य योगाभ्यम. सांख्य, सांख्य मीन्स एनालिटिकल. अगर आप बहुत सारे शास्त्रों का पढ़ाई किया, यू लर्न ऑल द वेदास, और बहुत सारे योगों का अभ्यास किया, योगाभ्यम, स्वधर्म परिनिष्ठस्य, अगर आपने अपने धर्म का भी बहुत अच्छा पालन किया, कौन सा धर्म, जो भी है आपका जो धर्म है उसका भी बहुत अच्छा पालन किया आपने, गृहस्थ धर्म, ब्रह्मचारी धर्म, वानप्रस्थ धर्म, जो भी आपने धर्म है आपका, एतावान सांख्य, सांख्य आपने बहुत चारों शास्त्रों का पढ़ाई किया, आपने बहुत योगा का अभ्यास किया, आपने अपने धर्मों का बहुत अच्छा पालन किया, और मनुष्य जन्म भी मिल गया आपको, उसका परम सार्थ क्या है? जब मृत्यु के समय आपको भगवान का नाम याद आ गया, इतना करना सुस्वामी जब प्राण तन से निकले. सो द हाइएस्ट परफेक्शन ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ इज अचीव्ड व्हेन यू रिमेंबर कृष्ण एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ. जब आपकी सांस निकल रही है तो आपके मुख से भगवान का नाम निकले, ये कभी पॉसिबल है? आगे शुक्रदेव गोस्वामी समझाएंगे. सो द हाइएस्ट परफेक्शन ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ इज टू रिमेंबर कृष्णा सुप्रीम पर्सनलिटी ऑफ गॉड एट एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ. तो बताइए अभी आप मुझे, हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल टू रिमेम्बर कृष्ण एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ, बताइए. हाँ, आपका नंबर नहीं आया, यहाँ से ऐसे आएगा, बताइए. भगवान को, दोज आवर फ्रेंड्स ऑनलाइन ऑल्सो कैन पार्टिसिपेट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू. यू कैन टाइप हाउ कैन वी रिमेम्बर कृष्ण एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ, बताइए. पास करना है तो पास भी कर सकते हैं. पास आपको पास?
पूरी लाइफ उसको प्रैक्टिस.
हाँ, प्रैक्टिस 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 प्रैक्टिस, दैट इज वन थिंग, दैट इज अ करेक्ट आंसर. एनीथिंग एल्स? कॉपी पेस्ट? आपका कोई आंसर? नहीं नहीं कैसे भगवान को. सो विलियम इज सेइंग डिवोशनल सर्विस इन द लाइफ विल हेल्प, दैट इज गुड आंसर विलियम, थैंक यू सो मच. आप बताइए. प्रैक्टिस सर.
सेकंड थिंग इज डेवलप अ रिलेशन व्हिच विल बी लविंग रिलेशन विद कृष्णा, दैट विल ऑटोमेटिकली मेक यू रिमेंबर.
वेरी गुड, दैट इज आल्सो करेक्ट आंसर. प्रतीक इज सेइंग टू रीड भगवद गीता, दैट इज सो करेक्ट आंसर. Okay, all these are correct answers, but Srila Prabhupada ji explains very nicely that if you associate with pure devotees, you will make your life easy. Satasanga, 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 satasanga. Agar aapka sang bura hai, to phir koi chance nahi hai. Koi chance nahi hai. So, absolutely correct. Practice is very important. So, what do? You practice every day. So, you chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra every single day. So Ujjwal ji is saying chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Pratik is saying when my grandmom was under that bed and unconscious, everyone around her was saying the name of Narayan. That is very good, right? So association is very important. Aapka sang kaisa hai? Sang vaisa rang. Aapka jaisa sang vaisa rang. So sang kaise hota hai? So what you associate with? You associate with TV, you get TV. You associate with WhatsApp, you get WhatsApp. You associate with Facebook, you get Facebook. You associate with Krishna book, you get Krishna. So you decide what you want. That is all. Sangha. Sangha is very important. So everyone needs some sort of association, and association of devotees is very important. So life should be molded. आपका जो लाइफ है, जीवन है, उसको ऐसा मोल्ड करना है सुबह से रात तक. ऐसा मोल्ड यानी वो प्लास्टिक रहता है ना, उसको मोल्ड कर सकते हैं. लोहे को मोल्ड कर सकते हैं, गर्म करना पड़ता है, लेकिन प्लास्टिक है तो ऐसा फ्लेक्सीबल. सो मेक योर लाइफ सच अ मोल्डेबल दैट इन मॉर्निंग टू नाइट एवरीवेयर यू गो यू फेस कृष्णा, दैट इज नॉट नोबडी एल्स हु कैन कम अक्रॉस यू. Because ante Narayana Smriti, you don't know when you are going to die. You can die while driving in a car also. You know, last week we had two weeks back we had an accident. One of our friend was driving. He was in the right lane, everything was good, but the truck came and killed him. What do you do now? Right? Nothing. But imagine at that time while driving, you are just remembering Krishna or hearing Krishna Katha. All you go back to home, back to God at Krishna Loka, because ante Narayana Smriti. Or if you're remembering something else, reading newspaper or reading and hearing news while you're driving and you die, will you be born as a politician probably? Right? Or if you are hearing some movie song, you'll be born as a hero or heroine taking some drugs, cocaine, charsi. What you get, what you like, you know. Krishna is very kind, he is very merciful, he will give you what you want. But ante Narayana Smriti is very important. So ant kal kabhi aayega bol sakte aap? Aap plane mein ja rahe hai, seedha niche aur seedha upar. Ant kal kabhi aayega kuch bol? Isliye insurance policy to zaruri hai. Everybody should have insurance, but better than insurance is Narayana Smriti, Bhagwan Krishna ka naam rakhiye. So this is very important. Next one is we 5 minutes and then we'll pause here. Further, Shukadev Goswami is saying. So Shukadev Goswami is saying, what is the highest perfection of human life? Ah, very nice, very nice. One attentive person. What is the highest perfection? And how do you get the Narayana Smriti?
Association
and practice and chanting the Maha Mantra regularly, reading Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam. In the real estate, when you go to buy a real estate, they say location, location, location. Right? Is that right? What is your location of the house? You will decide how good price and how quickly it will sell. So when you are going to buy the house, real estate agent will say location, location, location. In bhakti, it is association, association, association. Sangha, sangha, sangha. Jo aap karenge. If you association, association, and only association. More we associate with Krishna, you will get Krishna. More you do not associate with Krishna, you will not get Krishna. Only two choices, no third option. Koi do dusra tisra choice? In between nahi ho sakta hai. So how do you associate with Krishna? So you get up early in the morning, do whatever you have to do, then chant, do aarti, puja, do offering, eat Krishna prasad, associate, hear about Krishna katha, read Srimad Bhagavatam, chant the required rounds, whatever the rounds you decide. Some people chant one round, two rounds, whatever. You can decide whatever is comfortable to you. At least start with something. And then go to sleep. Hear something about Krishna katha. Plan something about Krishna. You know, if you want to do something for Krishna, then plan something. How can I spread message of Krishna or something like that. Think about it. Further, Shukadeva Goswami is saying, Prayena munayo rajan ramante sma guna anukatha nehare. Ramante sma guna anukatha nehare. So here, Shukadeva Goswami is saying that those who are devoted to Lord Krishna, those who are devotees, they always like to hear about Krishna katha. Everybody has a taste. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Taste ka ras. Sabko alag alag ras rehta hai. Kisi ko khatta ras acha lagta hai, kisi ko meetha ras acha lagta hai. Some people like Krishna katha. Some people like politics. Some people like other things, you know. So those who are interested, ramante sma guna anukathane hare. So those devotees who are interested in Krishna katha, they are transcendental because they like hearing about Krishna. Shukadev Goswami is appreciating Parikshit Maharaj because Parikshit Maharaj, instead of asking anything material, he's asking, tell me about Krishna Katha. So that is what Parikshit Maharaj is, Sukadeva Goswami is appreciating. Further, Idam Bhagavatam Nama Puranam Brahma Samhitam Aditavam Dvaparadau Pitro Dvaipanayad Aham. So Sukadeva Goswami is saying, Idam Bhagavatam Nama, this Bhagavat Katha which I am telling you, hey Parikshit, I learned this Bhagavat Katha from my Pitaru Dvaipanaya Aham. My father, Vedvyas Ji, I learned this Bhagavat Katha from my father. So, Idam Bhagavatam Nama, this Bhagavat Katha which I am telling you now, going to tell you now, I have learned it from my own father. Adhitvam Dvapara Adu. Dvapara Adu means at the end of Dvapara Yuga. I have learned this from my father. Who is the father? Vedvyas ji. Vyasdev, Vedvyas ji, the same personality. So here, Shukadev Goswami is telling a little bit about Bhagavatam, the Katha. Here, another name of Bhagavatam is Brahma Sammitam. Can you read this word? Idam Bhagavatam Nama Puranam Brahma Sammitam. Brahma Sammitam. This is different than Brahma Samhita. But Bhagavatam is also called as Brahma Sammitam. Why? Because this is approved as the essence of all the Vedic literature. Sammitam means the essence. So all the Vedas' essence is this Srimad Bhagavatam. So Shukadev Goswami is saying, this is my personal experience I'm telling you, hey Parikshit, that this Bhagavatam Katha, which I'm telling you, it is the Bhagavatam which I've heard from my own father, Vedvyas ji, at the end of Dwapar Yuga. And this is the summary of all the Vedas, the essence of all the Vedas. So this is the glory of Srimad Bhagavatam. At the end of Dwapar Yuga, I, Shukadev Goswami, studied this great Vedic supplement of Vedic literature named Srimad Bhagavatam, which is equal to all the Vedas, from my father, Srila Dvaipayana Vedvyas. So you see this here, the importance here is that Shukadev Goswami, even though he's learned, he's not telling that I'm telling everything from my own brain. He's telling this is coming from authority, Vedvyas ji. Vedvyas ji learned Bhagavatam from? Narad Muni. Narad Muni learned Bhagavatam from?
Brahma.
Brahma ji. Brahma ji learned Bhagavatam from? Bhagavan Krishna. This is a parampara system. So all this parampara system is coming from Lord Krishna to Brahma. Brahma se kaha hai? Narad Muni se? Vedvyas ji se? Shukadev Goswami. Shukadev Goswami ne kisko kahi? Parikshit Maharaj. Tabhi waha pe kaun baithe the? Suta Goswami. Suta Goswami ne kisko kahi? Shaunak Adi Rishi. Aur ye katha waise chalti aa rahi hai. तो फिर वहां से वो चलती चलती माधवाचार्य, फिर चैतन्य महाप्रभु, फिर भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर, भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती महाराज, शिल प्रभुपाद, फिर हमारे तक आ गई ये कथा। तो ये भागवत कथा ऐसे परंपरा सिस्टम में आ रही है। तो इसका इंपॉर्टेंस क्या है? तो व्हेनेवर वी लर्न दिस वैदिक लिटरेचर, वी लर्न फ्रॉम डिसिप्लिन, अथॉरिटी। यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ डॉक्टर, इफ आई बाय अ मेडिकल लाइक अ books from the library or from the bookstore and I study at my home, can I become a doctor? Aap software engineer ban sakte hai sirf pad pad ke? Aapko jana padega na kidhar dekhne ke liye, padhne ke liye, practical karne ke liye, kahan to jana padega, hai na? Waise hi, in the same way, if you really want to learn bhakti, you have to practice it under the authority. You cannot just do randomly. But tato mat jato mat. I will do aarti like this and like this. There is a process of doing the aarti. There is a process of doing deity worship. There is everything has a process. You know, you just can't do randomly. You decide to cook rice. There is a process of cooking rice, right? You take a chawal, then put some water. There is a quantity of water to be put, and you boil it for a certain time. You can't burn it. Everything will become black. There is a process for everything. Similarly, for doing bhakti also, there is a process. So you have to learn it. Like here, Shukadev Goswami is saying, I have learned from my father. I just didn't get it like this. No, I was not sitting under the tree and everything came like that. Log kehte hain, humme sab kuch malum hai. Theek hai. Kya karenge? Logo kehte hain, Bhagavad Gita padhi? Haan, bahut padhi hai. कभी पढ़ी थी आप? पढ़ी है, दे दाना दान, फेंका फेंक करते रोज पढ़ते हमारे पास मेरे पिताजी ने भी पढ़ी थी, मैंने भी पढ़ी थी, सबने पढ़ी है। फिर भगवान के मंदिर नहीं जाते, जब करते हैं नहीं करते, फिर क्या पढ़ा आपने? भगवद गीता का सारांश यह है, सर्व धर्मान परिजिते मामे कम शरणम व्रजः। अगर आपने पढ़ी है भगवद गीता, तो भगवान कृष्ण की शरण में क्यों नहीं गए? सो दैट मीन्स यू हैव नॉट रेड भगवद गीता एट ऑल, क्योंकि
अंडरस्टैंड
Well, if you read and you don't understand what is use of reading, then don't read. Better, why do you waste your time? Do something else. Watch a movie. Why do you waste your time if you don't understand? Go, and that is why it is said that you learn from the authority. You learn from the authority of scripture. You don't whimsically interpret the things way you want. You learn from the authority, right? So with that, we'll pause here. Anybody has any questions? Pratik is saying we need a spiritual insurance policy or company. Okay, Pratik, you will be the founder of that company. Spiritual insurance company founder, Pratik. Okay, Lalit ji is saying Krishna mantra up to the end of life. That is very nice. So anybody else having any questions? I want to thank Ajit ji, Anita ji joining us from New York, Lalit Prabhu joining us from Toronto. Then Nolin ji joining us from Dubai, Pratik Prabhu, Ujwal ji, William, all joining from Thunder Bay. And there are a few more devotees online. Want to thank you everyone for joining us. So now we'll do the aarti ceremony. If you have any questions, just keep your questions. We will take the questions after the aarti ceremony. Okay, beautiful darshan of Lord today. Next week is a lot of festivities coming up. So we have a very nice darshan. Please stay back for the darshan. We'll do the aarti ceremony. Next Tuesday is Ekadashi, which is 23rd. 24th is Dwadashi, where Varaha Dwadashi, where Lord Varaha's appearance day. And then we have Nityananda Trayodashi. Hare Krishna. Join us for the aarti ceremony.
Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Kiti Namine
Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Kiti Namine.